I'm Dr. Eric Fox, the Ionic Liquid Science Lead at NASA's Marshall Space Flight Center.
And I'm Dr. Jennifer Edmondson, a planetary scientist and In-Situ Resource Utilization Integration Lead for In-Space Manufacturing. Here at NASA's Marshall Space Flight Center, we are working with a material that, when mixed with Martian soil and cured by a dehydration process, will form a building material that potentially could be used to 3D print habitats, roads, or other structures. Additive construction is the process of 3D printing structures. It is exactly like additive manufacturing, but on a larger scale. NASA is interested in 3D printing habitats because it reduces the amount of building material needed, and subsequently waste material, when compared to traditional construction techniques, and it allows flexibility in the type of structures printed with the same device. NASA is also interested in taking the smallest amount of material necessary to build structures from Earth, because it takes a large amount of money and resources to launch and transport heavy items like construction materials. That is why NASA wants to use materials we can find on planetary surfaces, such as the minerals that make up the Martian soil. Quite a few minerals contain sodium and silicon dioxide. Two such minerals are albite and sodium bentonite. Both of these minerals exist on Mars. Our project uses ionic liquids to separate the sodium and silicon dioxide in the minerals, and then employs chemical processes to transform the material into our 3D printable binder material, sodium silicate.
Ionic liquids are a versatile class of materials that are potentially useful in many NASA-relevant applications. Of particular interest to this process is their ability to chemically dissolve Martian regolith, allowing for the recovery of high-purity single elements, such as sodium, from the soil. Additionally, as this process consumes no ionic liquid, no chemical resupply other than the initial ionic liquid mass will be required to allow for the processing of a theoretically infinite amount of Martian regolith. While the chemical process to produce cement-like materials using a sodium silicate binder is quite simple, the design of a cement that is both suitable for extrusion from a 3D printer, but that also provides the required mechanical properties to produce a structure is quite complicated. This study examined a number of properties of cement, such as the particle size distribution of regolith, the ratio of binder to aggregate, and the inclusion of additives such as glass fiber, and quantified the effect that these properties had on the suitability of use for particular cement compositions in 3D printing processes. Overall, the overlap of cement compositions that provide both suitability for printing or extrusion from a print nozzle while also providing the mechanical properties required to produce a structure is quite limited. However, further refinement of the process, in particular the design of custom 3D print heads designed for use with Martian regolith, should allow for this phase space to be expanded and the eventual construction of habitats on Mars using additive construction.